The very low reproduction rate of one calf per female every 8 years, elephant populations recover more slowly than many other animals. The elephant population therefore needs to be protected. For several years, Wildlife Conservation Society has worked with other stakeholders to address elephant conservation challenges and threats in the country by studying elephants.
Studying elephants in Makshan Falls National Park is to understand their feeding ecology, the movement patterns, is very important for us to identify the important corridors and also the preferred habitats so that we can protect them.
I'm Joshua, I'm a research coordinator of WCS. This is Makshan Falls National Park. We monitor wildlife here, including elephants and lions, and we do this snaring where we remove wire snares and wildlife poachers to save wildlife here.
I'm John Bosco Kilama. I'm a driver in WCS. I help field team in the Makshan Falls where we encounter poacher, and we help also in removing wire snares and monitoring the lions and elephants.
Use of snares to hunt animals for bushmeat is a challenge in Africa's protected areas. While the snares target smaller animals like antelopes, they also entrap, maim, and endanger other wildlife, including the pillar of Africa's ecosystem, the elephant.
Elephants are wide-ranging species which can traverse the landscape for covering a distance of about 100 kilometers or so. That means that we are able to think in terms of the actual home, you know, the ecological range within which we need to protect the species. And once you protect them, then you're likely to protect other species that, you know, survive within that particular geographical range. They also support the dispersal of seeds of species. They modify the landscapes, beautify by yanking the trees, and that helps to create a suitable environment or habitats for other species that graze and browse trees, like the antelopes, the Uganda cob, for example, the waterbuck, the bushbuck.